Hello everyone, my name is Pranay Aluria and today I am going to talk about how to get a job interview at Google. I had applied for a campaign manager role at Google and got my interview in August 2019. First time I thought of applying at Google, I thought my resume won't even get shortlisted for the role at Google. Then I made a strategy and understood what Google is looking for and how you can approach the Google interview. How you can really break and crack how to apply at Google, and that's what I did. And that's what I'm going to share in this video.
In this video, I am going to discuss about and talk about these things in detail. First, how to find the right role before applying. How to create a resume which gets you shortlisted and gets you the interview and job at Google. Third is how to ask for a referral and increase your chances of getting the interview at Google. Fourth, what to expect before on-site interview and during the on-site interview and how you can answer the questions. Fifth, how to answer open-ended questions which are majorly asked and which takes your each round forward. The last is a bonus tip.
I'm sharing my step-by-step experience and how I really applied for the interview at Google. If you're a digital marketer or a marketer or from any non-coding background, you should watch this video to get your dream job at Google. These methods can be used by anyone for non-Google roles as well and for the other interviews as well. The interview process at Google was very phenomenal and enriching for me. It taught me a lot of things about how to approach a problem, how to answer a problem and how to approach a job interview, particularly such as Google. Google sets a very high bar for its interviews and you meet a lot of phenomenal people while interviewing over Google Office. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. The first step is to find the right role for yourself. Let me show you how I found the right role for me and how I applied for it.
The first step to getting a job at Google is to first find the right role and the right job opening for you. You can go to Google and search for Google Careers and click on the link below. After clicking on the link, there is a job section on which you can go and see all the job roles which are currently open and available on the Google website. You can skip to jobs directly over here. Now there are certain sections. Let's filter out all these one by one. I'm putting location India. Skills and qualification. You can mention marketing. Job type full time. Organization, all the organizations being ticked, and you can see there are certain roles which are for non-technical and non-coding background and are related to marketing. If you're a digital marketer, then you see the top role is for a digital marketing strategist for their Hyderabad location in India. Let's see what are the details and what are the requirements for this role. So this asks for a bachelor's degree in engineering technology or any equivalent practical experience. In the preferred qualifications, they have not mentioned any post-graduation, MBA or masters. It requires you to have experience in data analysis, reporting and digital marketing. This also does not ask for a particular years of experience which is required for this role. Hence, this makes up for a perfect role for a digital marketer who have certain experience in digital marketing to apply for this role. The role which I had found and I had applied was for campaign manager. So for the campaign manager role, the requirement is for 4 years of experience managing marketing campaigns. In the preferred qualifications over here, it's still written MBA or masters in statistics, economics or engineering, but it's a preferred qualification, not a mandatory one. So you can still go and apply. If you work for some of the big digital marketing companies or big digital advertisers, this can be a relevant role and a highly relevant role for you. If you have been in traditional marketing field for let's say 3-4 years and you have worked on Google AdWords, Facebook ads, TikTok ads and any of these bigger platforms, advertising platforms, you should definitely apply for this. The second step is to have a great resume. How you can get a job at Google depends on how you create your resume and how effectively it tells what you have done in your career and how you can be a good asset to Google. This resume format can be used for any other job role as well. There are certain steps of building such a resume. I have also shared the template of this resume and you can use that and download it and use it for any other job for which you want to apply. If you're a digital marketer, you can specially use this format for any job role for which you want to apply. The first thing is a single page resume. As you can see, this is a single page resume and there are no other pages to it. Second thing is that the chronological order of the jobs in which you have worked. The last organization being on top and then talking about the previous work experiences which you have. The third thing is your education. Your education may or may not have your aggregates, and that is not a problem while applying for Google. And you can decide to put your education segment down below or on top, and it's totally up to you. The fourth aspect is having short sentences. The sentences should be to the point and should be able to tell what you have done and what you have achieved. There is no need to write complete sentences or full paragraphs of what you have been doing in your last jobs. Over here, as you can see, I have mentioned in the bullet points and I have written whatever I have done in my last job or in my last organization. The fifth point is highlighting and making the letters bold, which are important. Let's say if you are a digital marketer and applying for a campaign manager role or any other digital marketing role, you should mention the key aspects such as SEM, which is search engine marketing, display, YouTube, paid social, etc. The sixth point is highlighting the numbers and the key metrics. The numbers and the key metrics tell the recruiter or HR that the person has worked and he is on top of the numbers and is very analytically strong. Whatever project he or she takes up is actually driven by logic and analysis, and that's why they are able to achieve their goals and targets. That's why it's very important to mention the numbers, the metrics and the achievements which you have done in your previous jobs. The couple of things which you can exclude and they are not required in the resume are your marital status, your address, your date of birth. As you can see, I have not mentioned them anywhere over here. The seventh aspect is mentioning about the tools, certification or the technical aspects which you are very good at. This actually makes easier for recruiter or HR to go and directly see for which role you are most eligible and you will be the best fit. I have written over here the digital aspects for which I have shown my strengths and where on the tools and certifications which I have worked upon.
The third important step is asking for a referral. You can go to LinkedIn and search for the connections and the people who are currently working at Google. Once your request has been approved, very correctly talk to the person and provide your resume and the job link for which you want to apply. Referral really increases your chances for getting an interview at Google. One tip for finding connections on LinkedIn: do not go and directly approach a Google recruiter or HR. They will be receiving a lot of requests every day and they might not be able to respond to your requests and messages on time. Hence, you can approach a person who is not a recruiter and HR and then apply for your job role at Google. Be short and crisp in the messaging while applying and talking to the person. Once you get referred, you can expect a reply from Google's team within 2-3 weeks. That's the time generally a Google team takes to review your resume, to review your profile and how it matches with the job role which you have applied for. After your referral, the Google recruiter will schedule a telephonic round. The telephonic round is a screening round and is very important before you get an on-site interview at Google. The telephonic round is just to see your general cognitive abilities. What do I mean by general cognitive abilities? The recruiter or HR will see and try to gauge your problem solving skills. They want to see how you approach a problem and how you solve problems. They are not looking for exact answers, they are not looking for perfect solutions, but how you solve a question. The question and the problem can be very basic and can be a hypothetical question related to your work or not related to your work. Do not stammer and break the problem into multiple problems. Solve each problem and provide a solution and complete the question. Once the recruiter and HR sees that you have answered the question and you are eligible for the on-site interview, they will schedule the on-site interview with you and call you for the on-site interview at the Google office. Once the HR and recruiter has scheduled the on-site interview, they will be sending you in detail the do's and don'ts of the interviews, how you can approach the interview, what you can prepare for the interview, and what you can expect in the interview. The recruiter tries to help you as much as possible and prepare you as much as possible for the interview. They will send you a complete detailed guide to prepare you for your interview, the questions you can expect, how you can approach these questions, how you can answer these questions, and how you can do well in the interview. As I said, the interview rounds consist of multiple rounds, and each round is an elimination round. Even the telephonic round is an elimination round. So it's important to be well prepared and expect the questions and prepare the questions accordingly. Let's come to the fifth step, which is the on-site interviews. I am going to share a detailed analysis and detailed step-by-step guide how you can actually approach the questions which they ask you.
On the on-site interview, you will get a chance to highlight your strengths in these four areas. First of all, general cognitive ability. Google asks you open-ended questions to learn how you approach and solve problems. There is no right answer to it, but they want to see what is your thought process and how you use data to take informed decisions, and which is very important. Second thing they want to see is your leadership skills. Be prepared to discuss how you have used your communication and decision-making skills to mobilize others. They want to see if you have not been officially a leader, but in your role, you have the leadership skills and you have led teams to take things forward. Third is role-related knowledge. They are interested how your individual strengths combined with your years of experience can be helpful to Google at driving impact. Let's say there have been roles which are there currently with Google or the roles which are not there with Google yet, but your experience and your ability to get into role-related knowledge very quickly can be really helpful for Google, and that's what they want to know. Googliness. Googliness is all about how you are unique and distinct. Google comprises of a lot of people from different and various cultures and various backgrounds, and that's what they want to include more in their culture. So if you have the ability to work outside and grow outside of your comfort zone and bring something very distinct and very different to the table at Google, and which brings a highlighting culture to Google, they will definitely look that into you, and that's what Googliness is about. Now I'm going to share steps how to build a strong answer for GCA questions, which is general cognitive ability. I'm also going to share a sample question with you guys and how to solve for it. I will show step by step how to solve and arrive at an answer which I would have done in my question. The interviews are not allowed to share the exact question, hence taking a sample question for the questions ahead. Let's see the steps now. First of all, listen to the question clearly and write down all the points. Whatever points you have in mind and whatever comes to your mind, just write it down on a piece of paper which will be provided to you. Ask questions and clarify doubts. Do the cross questioning. Don't make it an interview which is only one-sided and the interviewer is only talking. You should be much more interactive in the interview round. Take logical assumptions and share it with the interviewer. The questions will be very open-ended. You can take some logical assumptions from your knowledge and share it with an interviewer and agree and disagree on whatever the interviewer has to say. Break problem into smaller problems. The bigger problem which you are looking to solve, try to break it into smaller problems and have an answer for each smaller problem and compile it and give a solution. The next step is compile and communicate your solution. The way you communicate and answer your solution is very important. It should be very seamless and it should be in a flow so that it's very understandable and you are able to arrive at a solution. The next is measure success and quantify. Whatever your problem is, it has to be measured and you need to measure it and quantify it and tell it if it is successful or not and you have achieved your target or not. Tie back the success metrics to the initial problem. Whatever the success metrics are and you are able to achieve it or not able to achieve it, tie it back to the initial problem to see what are the solution and what are the outcomes to it, and have a complete answer for the problem you had. Yep. So the sample question is, imagine you are made responsible for launching a new product of Google in India. How will you plan it? These are the clarifying questions I will ask. First, what kind of product it is? Interview says, this is an app to know more about your neighborhood in your city. Second question, is there any marketing budget available? Yes, $2 million USD. Is there a target of users acquired after launch? Yes, we are looking to target and acquire 1.5 million to 2 million users in the first week of launch. So let's see what are the logical assumptions you can have. Assumption 1. I will assume there is a PR team of Google. The product launch with media announcement will have reach and its effect. Let's say when the product is launched, the media, the bloggers, the news websites will be first one to take notice and will report highly for this launch. Assumption 2. The product will be most useful for the people in metros as they will have more things to explore in city and neighborhood. Assumption 3. As this is an app, the best way to reach users is digital and majority budget will go in paid app acquisition initially. Break problem into smaller problems. Estimate the target population eligible for the product in the top 6 metros in India with major population residing. The top 6 metros will have overall population of close to 90 million. This can be taken into consideration from adding up the population for the 6 major cities in India. Decide the channels to promote it through digital marketing. As Google is the biggest advertising platform and digital advertising platform, so Google's own channel will be the best to promote these for app installs and getting the visibility. As majority are Android users in India, with digital marketing expensive being in the top metros, the cost per app install can be taken at average of 1.42 USD. Now, how did I arrive at this figure? So the CPMs and the cost per install in India is cheaper as compared to the lot of other developed market, but still in comparison to the top metros versus tier 2 cities, it's expensive. That's how I'm taking it into consideration. Communicate your solution. First, I will assume that there will be a blog update on Google's website about the product, which will be actively covered by all media and websites. This can be done with the help of PR team. No marketing money required over here. Secondly, I'm assuming the CPI, the cost per install, to be at 1.4 USD for the paid digital marketing users in top 6 metros. Hence, achieving 1.4 million users through digital marketing and rest through organic PR and blog update. That means that I'm assuming and taking into consideration that the organic reach will also be there and that will also contribute to the app installs of the user and people getting on board on the app. Third, it will be important to retain the users on the app for the target to be achieved. The content will be in vernacular language wherever possible to have high traction on the app and for the app stickiness and so that the people retain much more on the app. Fourth, I will be sending a survey at the feedback form on the mail once user installs and logs in into the app. So this is my final communication and the final solution which I will be sharing it with the interviewee. Last, measuring my success. I will be sending out the survey and feedback as I said to assess how satisfied are the people with product. Measure average time spent and uninstall cohort in the first week compared to the older apps when they were first launched by Google. That will give you an idea and benchmark what are the numbers to look at and what is the success metric for Google in this case. Final number of installs and users after a week. Let's say the app stickiness is there, people retain on the app. It will be important to see what are the final number of installs. As Google wants its users to stay on the app, it would be important that the number which we were looking to achieve, which was 1.5 million users to 2 million users, remain there after the first week of launch. Last, was the plan and strategy successful and can be used in the future? If all the numbers and the targets are being met, that means the plan and strategy was successful and this can be used in future also. Let's say if it was not, then we go back to the survey and the feedback forms and then see what was which made the users unsatisfied. And in the first case, if there were no installs and the target was not achieved, why so? So these are some of the questions, sample questions, which are asked in other three aspects as well. Leadership. So they can ask you about what would you change in your last organization or tell us about a time when you had a difficult colleague to work with your team or if, for example, that you had a difficult project and you had a difficult colleague. So how did you manage to complete the project? Role-related knowledge. So questions related to Google Ads are asked technical questions about Google search, display, video are being asked, and especially when you are from a digital background. Build complete digital marketing strategies for big clients to scale their businesses. So Google Campaign Manager manages a lot big and huge budget campaigns and work with clients across US and Europe. So this is a kind of important question which they ask, and similar questions do they ask. Googliness. So for example, what do you do for fun? What are your hobbies? What do you like most about your hobby? So these are the kind of questions they ask. These questions can be prepared, and there are a lot more of such questions available on a lot of other websites such as Glassdoor and some of the blogs. So you can follow these and practice these questions and be strong about when you answer these questions to the interviewee.
These two books can really tell you about how Google works and can tell you detail about how you can approach a Google interview. This will really help you and align you with the Google interview questions and Google mindset. These two books are How Google Works and Work Rules Insights from Google. These are very well written books, and these are the best seller books. So you would obviously enjoy it. Even if you're not preparing for Google interview, do read them, and the links are given below for the Amazon for these two books. If you guys liked the video and enjoyed the video, do share your feedback and do mention in the comments what have you learned from this video. I am hopeful that you will get the interviews and the job at Google from this video. Thank you.